Oh, I can't see you, Greg, but.
No, he's not.
Okay. Thank you for joining Auto Network Reports. I'm your host, Roosevelt, and we will take you inside the auto industry like never before. And when I say we, I mean me. And who do we have today? Ah, I don't know. I can't find my screen. Ah, there they are. Oh, they were hidden for a moment. This technology, boy. You have so many screens open. Don't know where you are. We have Greg Morrison out of Hotlanta, Bumper to Bumper TV. And we have, talking about hot from New Mexico, Mr. Russ Heaps. Just Three Things video and beer to whiskey. You still doing Just Three Things, or you gave that up, Russ?
No, I'm still doing it. It's mostly all car stuff now, but I'm still plugging away at it.
Well, how's the beer to whiskey?
It's it's getting some traction. It's building up some steam. I'm getting some good shoots in the can, and I shot one while I was in New Mexico and in Albuquerque, and I just keep plugging away. I've probably got at least a dozen that I need to edit, and they get released every Thursday at noon, East Coast time, one a week. So
good.
Things are good.
You know, I before we get into our regular show, I finally set up an Instagram account. Any of you guys on Instagram?
Yes. Oh, yeah. Welcome to the 21st century, Russell.
Thank you. My focus has been, as you know, my main focus is YouTube. That's my staple. I can always rely on YouTube for everything. My fallback has been Facebook. And the only reason I decided to do something on Instagram is they have now gone to long form video, meaning up to 60 minutes. Because as you all know, most of the stuff that I shoot is long form. It's a lot longer than 60 seconds. I can tell you that, 15 seconds or 30 seconds. So people are finally catching up to me. YouTube used to tell me, nobody's going to watch long form video. I said, well, guess what? I'm not changing. So so they finally changed and went to long form. Now Instagram has changed and gone to long form. Facebook has been doing long form. So, but anyway.
Well, it's what I like, and this isn't a plug for Instagram because I really hate all this stuff. But the nice thing about Instagram is that when you shoot a photo and post it on Instagram on your smartphone, you can also post it to Twitter and post it to Facebook at the right. same time. That's the only reason I have Instagram, is so I can,
cross post.
I rarely shoot a photo.
I don't shoot as many as I used to, but I still shoot some.
You know, I'll shoot a quick video before I even think about shooting a photo. And I guess that's why I've kind of shied away from Instagram, because it's been pretty much promoted as a place to post photos.
So. Right.
But anyway, let's get into the show. We're running out of time here. It'll be 3:30 before you know it. Last week we were talking, just about every week we talk about recalls. And I think last week we were even talking about some of the manufacturers are telling people to park their cars. Guess what? Let me just go over a few more. NHTSA is urging Ford and Mazda to contact their truck owners to get their airbags repaired. These are the Takata airbags that everybody's been having a serious problem with. And basically the 2006 Ford Rangers and the Mazda B series pickups are the one that they're concerned about. Early in the year, Ford sent out an announcement to about 2,900 Ranger owners to tell them to stop driving their trucks, to park them until they actually get those airbags replaced. Now they have bumped that number up to 33,000. So this is serious. And like we were saying last year, this is not anything you play with, because if that airbag goes off unexpectedly, you can be in the car, your family can be in the car, and you're probably going to hit somebody next to you if you're out driving on the highway where there's traffic coming, or you're going to run off the road. And as we all know, when cars run off the road, they are automatically attracted to trees. Giant trees are like magnets for cars that run off the highway. It's unbelievable. So I would say, please, 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 you can go to safe, S-A-F-E, car.gov, enter your VIN number, and see if your car is under recall. It doesn't have to be a Ford or a Mazda. It can be any product, because most of the manufacturers now have some type of a recall out there. But these Takata airbags are serious. I think they're up to something like 2 deaths here in the States recently. And I think overall, nationally or internationally, there's been something like 22 deaths from these airbags going off. All right, what are we driving this week? Greg, what are you in?
I'm in heaven is what I'm in.
Uh-oh.
On Tuesday, I was delivered the Lexus LC500.
Oh,
sweet.
Thank you. That was my reaction. You know, my neighbors are accustomed to me driving various and sundry cars. This was the first time in a long time when folks from up the street, down the street, and around the corner came around to look at this car. And they are all walking away with their mouths hanging open. As you know, it's a beautiful car, 475 horsepower, extremely personalized, highly luxury. MSRP on this, $101,000.
And one for you and your wife.
Yeah.
And one for the, you know, for the grandkids too, you know?
Yeah. Hey.
I mean, it's just so sweet. You're right, Russ. It is a sweet ride. And it's one of these things, I want to find places to go in it just to enjoy the sensation. I'm in those suede seats. Oh my gosh, just wonderful.
And how many cup holders does it have?
One. I'm sorry, two. There's one in the back seat, one in the front. That's it. And I heard a great line the other day from someone from another manufacturer. He said that the issue of cup holders is moot now. It is now how many USB charging ports does it? USB
That's
charging
exactly
ports in the new
right.
cup holders.
Yeah.
Exactly right.
But yeah, it's a wonderful platform now. The back seat is a little more than a package shelf, not much more. But oh my gosh, what a wonderful experience. In fact, my neighbor next door today, her boyfriend came into town and she said, I want to surprise him. So would you mind going to the airport, picking him up and just tell him, I'm just telling him that I'm sending him a car service. Well, needless to say, he was like, wowzer.
Wow. I'm surprised you did it.
I had to go to FedEx anyway.
Oh, but I agree with you. That is probably right now the number one or number two best looking sedan out there.
It is a gorgeous car.
It is one. When I saw it, a couple of years ago in New York, I looked at that thing and said, whoa.
Yeah.
You know, yeah. Whoa.
That was my reaction. It's everyone's reaction around here.
Oh, yeah. Like I said, you look for places to drive it to.
I mean, and the best line, I pulled up at a stop sign the other day over in Decatur, and this guy who was doing road work for the county governor over there stopped and looked at it. He said, man, that's an invitation to a citation.
Yep. How about you, Russ? You in anything? I know you've been out on vacation.
I never sleep.
Uh-oh.
I never sleep. It's, you know, I don't rest. It's always push forward. Actually, I've got a 2018 Nissan Titan pickup truck, with the Midnight package on it. So everything is all blacked out. However, it didn't have a Monroney in it. And I didn't realize that until we went right into the green room. So I haven't done anything with that. But I will talk about a car that I had 2 or 3 weeks ago, which was a 2018 Mercedes AMG E43 sedan. Actually, you know, this is another really good looking car. Base price, $71,600. They had enough stuff loaded up on it that brought the retail price to $97,460. But it's a V6 by turbo engine, 396 horsepower, 384 pound feet of tree stump pulling torque. The surround sound stereo system, and it's a Burmeister. It's an amazing car to drive, handles great, looks good, sounds great. And you know, it's the E-Class, so it's got a fair amount of room inside. It was a lot of fun, and I wanted to be sure and talk about it because it's only the second Mercedes I've had in about 4 years. So I wanted
that's,
to.
That's two more than I've had.
Yeah. Well, no, both the ones I've had in the last 2 or 3 months. So.
Yeah, I've drove that car also, Russ, and it is like a wonderful road sedan.
Yeah.
You're looking for a long drive somewhere, because the one thing I noticed about it was the first time that I'd seen a Mercedes where the seats weren't uncomfortable.
Well, I'm in a 2018 Ford Raptor 4x4 Super Cab. It has a 3.5 liter V6 EcoBoost engine, 450 horsepower, and Russ, 510 pound feet of torque.
You've always got to one up me, don't you?
Hey, man, 10 speed automatic transmission with a tow mode. Exterior color, which I love, which is great for photography, is this lightning blue. Interior is black leather bucket seats, 15 miles per gallon city, 18 highway, 16 combined. And this is on the cheap side, $64,100 compared to you guys. But
affordable side.
Affordable. Yeah, this is a short bed, as you can see. And it has what I like about it. It has, a power tailgate. Now, the only thing that would beat lowering, if you could push the key fob and it would close it.
Yeah.
Like you have on some of the lifts on some of the cars, it will open and close. But again, use your key fob to open it. It's the Raptor. As you all know, the Raptor is they're trying to be the Ram killer on the highway. And this is one massive looking truck. It's menacing on the highway. If you can look at these tires in a side shot, they are humongous. The treads on them look like this truck will take you any and everywhere. It is 4x4. So if you really want to go off-road, or if I want to pull down one of the trees that I'm parked in front of, I could throw a cable around it and tow it down the street. I like the sliding rear window, which is built in, and right there, you can't even tell there's a middle sliding window that opens. I like the way they black that out, so you can, it doesn't look as obvious as the old sliding screens where rear windows, where you had the framing built around it. It's very nice. And the running board there is different. A lot of open space. The inside, I love the interior. And this is what I really like about it, is the opposing doors when you open it. So if you want to get something in and out of here, you have some young kids who you want to pile in real fast, that's the easy way to do it. As you can see, the rear seats fold up to give you a lot more rear space. It has, 11.5 inch ground clearance. So you can pretty much run over anything out there off-road without damaging the underframe. And you were talking about cup holders. There are plenty of cup holders, but there are also plenty of USB ports and regular power outlets, which is unbelievable. I think this truck has two regular power outlets and something like five USB ports, if I'm counting correctly there. What do you guys think?
Well, I've always loved that color on the Fords. And they have basically made this Super Cab, you know, as appealing as possible. It's not just a work truck. It's also a luxury experience, you know, in the truck line. And with the 10-speed transmission and the EcoBoost platform, you know, it works. I think Ford is, you know, holding their own ground in the light-duty truck segment. You know, they're not ceding anything to anybody. And to me, that's where the next big wars are going to be among manufacturers. Who can come up with the best light duty truck or the most appealing light duty truck? And Ford's already staked out their ground.
It's every year the Texas Auto Writers have what they call the truck rodeo, where they bring in all sorts of trucks and SUVs, and I'm sure you guys are familiar with it, but for the viewers at home, it's a big deal, and the manufacturers really throw a lot of effort into it. They bring the best of the best they've got. They bring a lot of their engineers and things to talk to us, and on the strength of the Raptor, I think the Ford F-150 was voted the truck of Texas last year, and it was simply because of the Raptor that pushed it over the top on it. So it's a highly regarded vehicle. It's a blast to drive. It's very capable, and Ford obviously has a winner on their hands.
Yeah, and those seats are heated and cool seats. You get a lot of what I would call car amenities in this pickup truck. And as you all know, pickup trucks now are getting to be like automobiles. Not only can you drive them on the highway and they're very comfortable, you can obviously immediately go off road and still not get bounced all over while you're on the off road track.
Did any of your neighbors want you to go swamp riding with them?
All my neighbors did was look and say, that's one big truck.
That it is.
You know, it's the wheels that make it look larger than what it is, because it is a short bed truck. So it's not like you can't park it easily. You can park this thing very easily. You just, the guy that delivered it to me said, you have to be careful with the width, because it's about as wide as you can go legally to drive in a lane on the highway. So you have to watch when you're going down the road. You know, you can't be drifting over the line with this thing. But anyway, that is the 2018 Ford Raptor 4x4 Super Cab. And that's what I'm driving this week. And it's still parked out front next to some construction boards, because we're having the townhouse here. They're doing a lot of maintenance work, which means that our condo fees will go up. But that's another story.
Yay!
That's another story. You know, talking about trucks, when I sent you all the show invite, I had on there incentives. And this is our, number 187th show. So maybe if we make it to 200, we'll have a party or something. Who knows?
Well, anyway, I recommend that Russ bring the beer and the whiskey.
Yeah, right. Russ has some contacts all over the country now, probably around the world.
A little redemption ride, Russ, would be right on time.
Yeah.
I can make that happen.
You know, I had in the heading incentives, and it's interesting that we had both Greg mentioned a Titan truck. Was it Greg? Yeah, Greg mentioned.
No, Russ mentioned the Titan.
Russ mentioned the Titan, and I have the Raptor. And I was watching a TV commercial last week, and it shocked me. They were talking about $16,000 incentives, in some cases $17,000 incentives on pickup trucks. The pickup truck war has heated up, folks. You can literally go out there now and get a pickup truck, and with $16,000, you can pick up a Fiat.
If you can find a Fiat showroom,
right. I mean, you can go home with another new car. And just to give you an idea, I think I wrote down here some of the numbers. What did I do with it? Here we go. $16,000 on the Ram. The Ram had $16,000. I forgot what Ford was.
Yeah, it's crazy.
If you're out there looking for cars now, and I think everybody by now knows that Ford is getting out of the car business, so they say.
You know, I don't know if you guys have talked about this because I've been away. This is my first time back here for about a month. But, you know, I think that is one of the most short-sighted things ever. I don't get it with going towards as we continue marching towards an autonomous vehicle, which screams city, screams smaller, screams car. I don't get it. It's like they're tone deaf, like they're not paying attention to the market. And the fact that they sell a lot of trucks, I get that. But to just walk away from cars entirely makes no sense to me whatsoever in the long term.
Well, you know, for a company like General Motors, this is like best gift they've ever gotten. Walking away from passenger sedans. You got Fiat Chrysler basically giving up on most of their passenger sedans. So that leaves a brand like, I say, a Chevrolet in the catbird seat, because they've got all kinds of vehicles, depending on what size of passenger sedan you want. So, you know, I'm talking with the GM exec the other day, and they're just sitting there like, we're waiting for it, son. Bring it on, son.
Yeah.
And, you know, what you're going to see is the wars for the passenger sedan market will be General Motors, Toyota, Nissan, Hyundai, Kia.
You know, Ford may not be as dumb as we may think they are by getting out of this. Because if you've ever looked at any of the real autonomous cars that are coming, they don't look like anything we currently drive. I mean, they're cubes, they're people move. You can get different versions. You can have a platform where it can be for 2 people, 3 people, 10 people. I mean, and they don't look like traditional sedans. So they may be looking to say, hey,
you have to develop these things.
Well, they're out there. I mean,
Ford doesn't have them out there.
No, but if you've gone to the latest auto shows, which we all have, they sitting off to the side, they have these autonomous looking people movers. I think one is called the Ollie, for instance. It seats about
seats 8 people. Like I went to the Intelligent Transportation Society meeting in Montreal last October, and they had a lot of these platforms there. But the first thing is, even the folks at ITS will tell you, these are not, the vehicles that they had there were not designed for individual ownership or family ownership. They were designed for corporate shuttles, business shuttles, that kind of thing. And they'll be the first to tell you, for this kind of technology to really to take hold, it's got to be in a platform that you want to be seen driving to the grocery store in, or to the golf, you know, to the golf course or whatever, something, you know, that's got a bit of style. Because while we all claim we want to be in with the latest technology and so forth, we still want to look cute while we're driving. We still want to look good while we're driving. I mean, let's face it, the reaction we all had to that Lexus tells me that we all want to be in something that gets people's attention and make people turn their head. And whether it's powered by all electricity or it's autonomous or not, you still want to have something that makes you want to look at it and say, yeah, I want to drive that.
Well, I think the first test, the real test, will be the success of these subscription programs where the person does not own a car. And a lot of these autonomous cars that will be coming out in the future will be subscription type services where literally you can order a car. And in the next 10 minutes, by the time you get downstairs or outside, it's out there waiting for you to be whisked away. And while you're doing whatever you have to do, instead of sitting in a parking lot, taking up space, it's off on another task. And when you're ready to leave, again, you call the car, and it may not be the same one, but something similar to that will appear there. And you're seeing that happen now. If you go to the airport, you look at, remember when Uber first started, people used to talk about Uber wasn't going to work. At our airport now here in Charlotte, they have a Uber and a Lyft stop, which is right behind the taxi cab lane. And the cab drivers, as you all know, are extremely upset. So these types of services, yeah, we may want to look good getting from point A to point B, but we are getting older, and all we want to do is to get from point A to point B, because we're going to be walking around with our walkers and canes. And we'd be more than happy to call a car to come pick us up. So,
Well, Roosevelt, I'll get you your motorized wheelchair for that.
You know, so but, I think attitudes are changing, and all of these different types of programs and services now are testing to see what we will do. And so far, we are making changes. You know, we are making the changes.
You want to talk about changes? You ought to see the changes going on in Germany. Russ, did you see what happened with the president of Audi this week?
Oh, yeah.
Walked out. The newest accessory for the Volkswagen line, handcuffs.
Yeah.
Yep.
That's not going to be pretty.
You know, I think, and I just want to jump in. I think something worth noting is that the J.D. Power IQS, the initial quality survey, got posted this week. And the top three brands for the fewest problems per 100 cars are Korean. Genesis, Kia, and Hyundai are the top three brands in the initial quality survey. And this is the fourth year in a row that Kia has been the top non-premium brand in that survey. And I just think that's worth mentioning or interesting. And also,
it's on my list.
Oh, is it? And well, sorry for stepping
that's okay.
On.
No.
But the interesting thing is that most of the problems reported aren't mechanical anymore. They have to do with the infotainment systems and how complicated they are and difficult to operate. And the reason that Power says Genesis, Kia, and Hyundai are doing so well is they have very simple, easy to use infotainment systems, unlike many of the cars farther down on the list. So I just thought that was an interesting thing.
Yeah, you know, if you've known me any length of time, when people ask me even years back, what should they buy? I've always said Hyundai or Kia. And now when people ask me about what should they buy, I throw in Genesis. And I think last week I mentioned that an uncle of mine who drove Mercedes and BMWs, and he just switched to Genesis, and he cannot say enough about that automobile after coming out of full-size sedans, Mercedes-Benz, and full-size BMWs, and to get into Genesis. I've never heard him talk about a car so much as he's talked about the Genesis. And when the J.D. Power is based on the fewest number of problems in the first 90 days of ownership. So that's taking somebody who's literally trying to get used to the car itself. And we've always talked about the entertainment systems are the biggest downfall of these cars. That's what people complain about. But also on that list, which I found amazing, at the bottom of the list, at the bottom of the rung is Land Rover, right above it is Jaguar, and right above that is Volvo. So,
well, again, J.D. Power's explanation is that their infotainment systems are so difficult to operate, so complicated, and so full of glitches that, it's really skewing them all the way down to the bottom of the list. And the other interesting thing I found was Fiat doesn't even appear on the list because Fiat didn't sell enough cars.
Right.
There wasn't a big enough survey pool to get numbers from. That is kind of scary.
That's not a good sign.
Auto Pacifica came out with their 2018 vehicle satisfaction awards, and the top award went to the Genesis G90.
Kevin Smith is probably grinning from ear to ear right about
now. Oh, yeah. So Genesis is at the top of the list.
Well, we're all familiar with this, and civilians wouldn't know these things or be familiar with them. But the Koreans, all three of those companies, those brands, are notorious or famous for, however you want to look at it, split second, turn on a dime changes.
Yep.
If there is something wrong, they'll stop the line. They'll, and I'm not talking about making little changes. They will make a sweeping change right in the middle of things to correct a problem that they have found or that somebody has brought to their attention. And that sort of responsiveness, I think, is one of the things that's helped propel them to the top of that list.
You know, to echo that, we were in Hawaii a few months ago with the Kona.
Yep.
Hyundai. And the president of the company was there. And all he wanted to know were the problems. What are the problems? What are the problems? And he had, you know, guys right next to him taking notes, writing down. And the PR guy, who was the handler for him, said, you know, we'll probably have those changes made in the next couple of weeks.
Well, I think it was the Kona that several of us on that trip remarked about how the front passenger seat didn't have any adjustment and sat a little low in most of our opinions. And they were really interested in that. And I'll be interested to see how they address that or if they address it. I'm sure they will.
Couple more things. We're right at the half hour here, but Tesla Model S caught fire in California. They don't know why, but you can watch the video. I'm sure it's probably been seen several hundred thousands of times.
Is Tesla still in business?
Oh yeah.
Okay. All right.
Auto Nation and their annual Drive Pink, which is a breast cancer awareness week. I guess it is a month. They've up their ad budgets of something like $25 million to promote Drive Pink or breast cancer awareness. So again, I want to commend them on doing that. Russ, you came back, man. The show went so fast because you participated.
I am happy, pleased as punch to be here.
I am glad to see you. Good to know you're doing well. Greg, good to see you. You're the old staple. You're here most of the time to keep it going. I thought last week I was going to be here by myself.
And I wasn't going to leave you hanging.
But Greg popped in, and hey, we had a dynamic duo, and we had a couple of comments on the show last week. Those guys really know what they're talking about. So we fooled them again, Greg.
Fooled them again.
But this is Roosevelt with Auto Network. As always, please buckle up. Don't drink and drive. Buckle up. Don't text and drive, and Frank would say if he was here, buckle up, don't stream and drive. You can find us on YouTube. You can find us on Facebook. And pretty soon you'll be able to find me on Instagram.
Woohoo!
Which will be new to me. So thanks, guys, for taking the time. See you next time.
Take care, everybody.